La ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah. Muhammadun Rasulullah.
In the name of Allah, the most gracious, the most merciful. Jabir radiallahu anhu said, he saw once the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam at the night of a full moon. So while he's seeing, he was simultaneously looking at the full moon and also at the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And he finally came to a conclusion that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was more beautiful, handsome and radiant than the moon. Why? Because his face was more beautiful. This is the messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam that the whole world should be following. This is the messenger of Allah that the 21st century of Muslims should be taking as a role model. Why? Because Adam alayhi salam was sent to a nation. Nuh alayhi salam was sent to a nation. Ibrahim alayhi salam was sent to a nation. Ismail alayhi salam was sent to a nation. Ishaq alayhi salam was sent to a nation. Dawud alayhi salam was sent to a nation. Ayub alayhi salam was sent to a nation. Then, like this, many prophets has come for every nation. So this, you have being heard that the Quranic ayahs also like saying there is no nation we have not sent prophet and we are not going to punish them. So this is totally a logical one. Then this, the messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam surpassed a lot of them and he was sent to the whole of mankind. So this is the messenger of sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the whole world should be following. So the messenger of sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the best example that ever stepped on the face of this earth. Before I get through, let me greet you all on the way that our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa ta'ala wa barakatuh. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Holy Quran in chapter number 21, Surah Al-Anbiya, verse number 107, that and we have not sent you, O Muhammad, except as a mercy to the worlds. So here the words, that one thing, that half of this verse goes to some other scientific meaning. So the words that when you come to the verse, when you see the first surah, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, the very first verse of the surah, it has many different meanings. So Rabbul Alameen, if you take this verse alone, it has been repeated Alameen 72 times. So the people have found out that planets, where many planets are there, universe is there, and something like this. The many thing has been found like this on the thing. So my topic is totally different. So my topic now today is, why not our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is a role model? So today you may see many people, everybody, they are getting inspired for the someone who is not at all in use. If you go, for example, if you go to a shop, take an apple, for example, take an apple. So we have a rotten apple and a best fresh apple. So what will we hope to? We'll be obviously hoping to the fresh one. So the same thing, the concept is applied over here. So we want to select the best one. So it is also said in the hadith that in Sahih al-Bukhari, it's coming from volume number 1, book number 2, hadith number 14, that Anas radiallahu anhu narrated that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, none of you is a believer until you love me more than his father, his children, and all the mankind. My dear brothers, today, at the present scenario, we see people like they are on the spot, they are standing at the mirror, when they are combing their hair, why they look like Messi or Ronaldo, or looking at that side and this side, making that why we are not looking like this or something. So my dear brothers, this is totally a foolish way. You have to know that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was the best role model. Because we are not following Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, there's a big misconception outside. Because you have to see that one of the YouTube videos which I was surfing yesterday, the headline that read is that the Muslims, the book that Muslims are scared to read, The People versus Muslims, trailer 2016. So this is what book trailer. So this was written by J.K. Shenlin. So he is something like non-Muslim, I guess. So he's a Christianity, I don't know properly the thing. So he, on the very, in the trailer, on the very first thing he shows the September 11th, 2001. You would have seen the two aeroplanes coming and crashing, the World Center, the Twin Tower and everything. So that scene is showing, and the other scene is coming that Muslims are doing terrorism, that Al-Qaeda, ISIS, this everything, they are showing on the other side. On the other side, they are saying the Muslims are the one who is doing rape, adultery, child molestation, anti-Semitism, terrorism, and organized crimes, and many more. So we have got this name today just because we have not followed Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. My dear brothers, remember very carefully that Shaitan is everywhere. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, in chapter number 2, verse number 208, that, O you who believe, enter into Islam completely and perfectly, and do not follow the footsteps of the Shaitan. And indeed, he is to you a clear enemy. So what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is actually coming to say, the footsteps. So what is this footsteps is about? When you come, a part of his footsteps will be like showing that he was a good Muslim. He was obeying Allah, worshipping Allah. Another part of his thing was he was elevated really high, so high that he was the level of angels, although not the angel himself. But what here the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says is that it's totally opposite. This is like the person who is getting so proud. So that's the footsteps is saying. So the pride is called kibir. So when you are, whenever you go out or something, like you feel sometimes like the pride, you like show like, you know, hey man, you know, who am I? I'm a big shot man, something, you go there and say that. So that shows your pride. So the pride means kibir. So what is kibir? The kibir, from the showing off, it leads to kibir. The kibir leads to shirk. Shirk leads to hellfire, and may Allah save us all from that. So, now, who created this evil? A lot of people are saying that the evil was created by the devil. If this was the concept, the devil has to have a power. If the devil has power, then Allah has a competition. If Allah has a competition, then there's somewhere power split out somewhere there. Then that shows that shirk, it caused shirk, and we don't believe in that. So according to us, nobody created evil except Allah. Allah created evil. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, in Surah Al-Falaq, chapter number 113, verse number 1 to 5, say, I seek refuge in the Lord of Daybreak from the evil that which He has created, from the evil of darkness which when it settles, from the evil of blowers of knots, and from the evil of envier when he envies. So this is what you read it in Arabic, as kul a'udhu bi rabbil falaq min sharri ma khalaq wa min sharri ghasiqin idha waqab wa min sharri naffasati fil uqad wa min sharri hasidin idha hasad. So this is the verse, and this in the very second verse, it proves that Allah has created the evil thing. So this is nothing but a test for you. So you can't blame Allah. He is only creating the evil, and He is only saying us to pray. He is only asking us. He is making us to do this and that. Because Allah has already said in the Quran, I have not created jinn and mankind for any other purpose except to worship me. So this verse comes from chapter number 51, verse number 56, as I said at last Juma speech. So the brothers, another thing we see is that we have known that Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam has a very good thing. So very first thing I want to say here is, on the Day of Judgment, who is going to be there? Who will help you? Today you will go off and think, just Allah is there. We will see. What you will see, my dear brothers, what you have done, such a good deed. Have anybody have a guarantee if you die right now, you will go to paradise? Obviously nobody can raise a hand. Nobody can raise a hand. Such is the condition of ours. But still, we are staying in this world like as if we have done a big thing. We are a scholar. We have done a PhD in Islamic studies and all the things and everything. So we are staying in such a position. So this proves that the misconception of outside. So this is why it's coming, the root cause. It's we. I want to prove that it's we. So we can't blame others. It's like you are throwing sand on yourself and asking who threw the sand. You are turning back and asking who threw the sand. Brothers, listen very carefully. Islam gives you a very perfect way of life. It says in chapter number 3, verse number 19, Inna deena illallah al-Islam. Surely the way of life acceptable to Allah is Islam. But what we do, today you see, the hashtag. I already said about this, but I just want to quote a small reference. So the hashtag. You see, the Messi today hits a goal somewhere else with a new hashtag. I said that hashtag is Messi. But nearly like 10 years to 20 years back, a Tamil comedian did the same hashtag. He came up with the same hashtag. The people loved it. That time he was a comedian. But today the same hashtag was keeping by Messi or Ronaldo or someone else. We are saying that's the beautiful trend. Such is our condition, my dear brothers. Where are we leaving? And where are we leading to? Our Muslim direction is somewhere else and we are taking some other direction. You see that? That's why Prophet said, don't have the pride. If you have an atom of pride, you will be like going to hell. So this, he says, because the small reason can drill you for everything. So this is the small reason. Take, today I am having a prideness. Now today I am showing off in front of you that I can do speech, I know this verse. So today I will show that, show off. Tomorrow I will go to a big stage and I will show like, yeah, I did this, I did this. But when I go to Day of Judgment, all is waste. What I said is waste. Allah will say, you didn't do for me. If you have done for me, I will allow you for the paradise. But you are not done for me. You are done for someone else. You are doing for the people to show the esteem in the other's eyes. So my dear brothers, don't show prideness. And the other thing is that you want to see one of the incidents that happened, like Prophet ﷺ kissed his two grandsons, Hassan and Hussein. And when he was kissing, that one he kissed on the mouth and the other on the neck. I think so you all have known this story. So looking at this, Fatima radiallahu anha comes and by the strange behavior, she asks, oh Rasulullah, why you did so and so like this? So he says that one of my grandson will be died by giving him poison food, and the other will be like cut down his neck with a sword. So then he says, the Fatima radiallahu anha, the daughter says, you may say that dua, that special dua which every prophet has got. So when she says this, the Prophet also refused. Why? Because he kept that dua only for us. His community, his ummah, who is that? It's we. But look at us, being funny, sitting in the masjid, so cool. I'm not blaming my dear brothers, please don't think I'm blaming. This should be a talk everywhere. According to my theme, I want to prove that we are doing some mistakes. That should be correct by us. Because most of them are not saying this. So according to me, that's the concept. So we are sitting cool on the masjid, calling the fools around, and we are saying that we have a very great culture. What culture did you have, my brother? Cutting your hair 360 degree, what is there? Showing your hair and say, what is there? Wearing a dress half naked. This Prophet also already said, dressed but unclothed, that dressed but naked. That's happening today. So when you take a type of cloth like this, it's valuable and it's costly. But today, which is transparent, there's no material at all in it, but we are going for it. But it's costly. What a foolishness we have behaved. This is the foolish thing we are behaving, and we are going like the culture somewhere else. My dear brothers, remember Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was a very good role model. Even in that trailer, they are like quoting that the Prophet himself claims that he is perfect. Then they are quoting the verse of chapter number 68, verse number 4. So it says, this is Surah Al-Qalam. So it says that he is an exalted character, some character, he has the best of character, something like that. So this they say because they don't believe that Quran is from Allah. My dear brothers, if some people you find they are asking like this, just ask them what the meaning of Alif Lam mean. If anybody asks that the word meaning Alif Lam mean, even the Prophet doesn't know. Why? Because that's the word known only to Allah. So this proves that it's the word from Allah. So most of us will not believe. The very first thing, the very second surah, Allah says in one of the verses, the very first nearly verses, He says like, it's an open challenge to you. Whoever can write a similar book like this, you can. He gives an open challenge. But still today, nobody can do it. If you ask them, they'll do the similar one. For example, a John came to the Egypt He was the prophet there. He was giving the people guidance. They can do only this. They can't give a new revelation. You see, even each and every revelation has some other meaning. You take one surah, that will have several meanings. You take one ayat, you have several meanings. You take why it comes on the 22nd surah or 23rd surah, that has another meaning. Everything has been, no contradiction is there still now. But people are still arguing because of our carelessness. We are not properly following the Islam. The role model the Prophet ﷺ gave was the best one. You have to see that he was having the hairstyle like full back, from still back it comes. So other things from near the ear or something. But how much of us really followed it? Today I could see people, they are following this but having a band inside. What's that? My dear brother, you can put comb fully there, put a cap, you look so ibadah. You look a religious person. But why not be opting to it? Such a bad condition we are going, my dear brothers. Seriously, I'm like regretting. Even, I'm not saying only you, it's me too. I'm always remembering, I'm saying the word we. So it reminds that it's you and me. So both together. So my dear brothers, don't think that you are going to escape from death. In the surah itself, it says that even if you are in a high built tower or something else, the death will come and find you. It says that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in chapter number 3, verse number 185, again in chapter number 21, verse 35, again in chapter number 29, verse number 57, that kullu nafsan dha'ikatul maut. Every soul shall taste death, surely. So my dear brothers, do you think you can escape the death? You go hide yourself in somewhere, go to the fortified towers, or go to the palace, king's palace, go to the Trump's home, sit with him, your death will find, even you have 1,000 blackguards, your death will come. One of the story I was seeing one of the bayan about Sulaiman alayhi salam, the angel, the malaika of death. He is getting shocked by seeing a person. So when he came, he was there, Sulaiman alayhi salam was talking with the person. That person, he was looking, the malaika was there. Those times the people could see the jinns alone. So he is seeing, he could see the person who is sitting, he could see the someone sitting there and he is looking strange at me. Then he said like, this person is looking strange at me and I am going. So he left the place. He left the place and that, after that this Sulaiman alayhi salam asked that, why you looked at my companion like that? So he says that, this soul was to be taken in India. This is a very quoted thing. He says that this soul was to be taken at India, but I found it here. And the very next moment, when he said the before the thing, the previous scene, is that the Sulaiman alayhi salam, when the person said, he said, please make me move somewhere else with the wind you have, because he had all the powers. So with the power, he made to move. So he was directly moved to India. So the malaika directly went, he get his soul and left. So the decree, the book of decree is wrote, ink is dried. Nobody can change it now. So your death is fixed. So my dear brothers, follow Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam perfectly. And one more thing is that why we are ashamed to follow Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's sunnah, the aspects of his life and everything. Why are we ashamed? When we are not ashamed of listening to the music while going in the streets, but why are we ashamed to listen to Quran in the public? When we are going and saying the man, hey sup man, you say like that and you go, and when you say that, like you don't feel ashamed. But when you are going to say Assalamu Alaikum, you are feeling such a shame inside. Brothers, remember that one of the hadith has been like put up there a few days ago or a month ago, that it's a sign of resurrection, the day of judgment, that a person will say salam to his brother only by acquaintance. Acquaintance is by like, if I know you, if anyone I know you, I'll just say to you salam and leave the place. A group of people is standing, a new person is coming, we are not going to say salam. That means it's a day of judgment sign and it's already has been came. So my dear brothers, to conclude, it's my kind request, please follow Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam's sunnah. Because it's who we are. Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the messenger of us. Obey Allah and obey his messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Because it shows that who we are. So what? If you sit down and urinate, it is who we are. So what? If you grow the beards, it is who we are. So what? If the Muslim women wear niqab or hijab, It is who we are. So what? If the Muslim use the brush, I mean like the stick for brushing the teeth, if that shows it's who we are. So we are Muslims and we are the followers of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and never forget this, never forget this. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.